Do you want to use Cursor in your terminal? If so, this video is for you. We will be installing Cursor CLI in under 5 minutes. Cursor CLI is actually in beta buzz at the moment, and there's actually no separate subscription from Cursor to Cursor CLI, and it's perfect for terminal native workflows and multimodal power. In layman's terms, what does that really mean for everything else? You can run things in parallel, put it into CI/CD processes. You can really start using it as an automated engine, and it's powered with Cursor's coding techniques under the hood. So what's there not to love? Anyway, let's jump into the installation. See Cursor CLI on screen, built to help you ship straight from your terminal. We're literally just going to grab this link here, the curl command, which is going to install to our system. Pretty much will work the same for anyone. So we're literally going to copy and paste that, going to run it and install. Great, it's installed. And it's even telling us the next steps. So we can see, you know, we need to add to local bin to the path. So this is just so it on boot, it always has access to it. So you can literally just copy these commands and execute it. I'm on .zsh here, so I'm literally just going to copy this. We're going to first do this one. That's literally going to copy, and then source is just to restart the terminal. So it will be executed. With that, the terminal restarted. Now we can literally just run Cursor agent, and we can see Cursor is installed. Great. So we can see Cursor agent is there, and this is telling us pretty much it's still evolving, so use it on your risk. All right, so we've just installed Cursor agent. So straight off that, we just need to log in, and we just going to use the command Cursor agent login, and we're just going to hit that. It's going to take us to the Cursor page. I'm going to blank my email address here, but essentially it just asks, like, do you want to log in? And you just say yes. And if we go back to the code, it's pretty much logged in successfully. And now we can run Cursor agent. So Cursor has pretty much all the standard ones that you could think. You could go .model, and you can choose between GPT-5 and Codebase. You can see there's auto run. So if you don't want to approve everything, you can set auto run. There's also clear. There's even a Vim mode to toggle between Vim keys. What we're going to do, we're just going to make a quick conversation, ask it about the code base. And I don't really care what the result is. What I want to show you is how you can actually come back to previous conversations using Cursor. So at the moment, we can see in terms of the model using GPT-5, and we can see it's just ran a quick scan of the code base, and hopefully it will give us the answer back. One thing while we're waiting for Cursor CLI, it actually works with your Cursor rules files, which is really great. So if you're using Cursor rules file, your terminal, and you run it in your project, it'll actually just grab your Cursor rules file. We can see it's grabbed our information of this project, and we can just write exit or quit to quit from it. But we can go Cursor agent resume, I believe it's resume, and this will resume the last conversation. We can see it's taken us straight back there. In command mode, so say if you want to put into a CLI, you can use Cursor agent and then give it a message. Something joke, for example, very creative. And we can see it runs it straight away. This is quite powerful because you can actually then put this in CLIs and run it. And it'll actually pick up the rules for the code base, which is great. So just exit this again. This is clear. And let's just do the agent.ls to see if it picks up. So we can see it got the joke teller and the thing. So very nicely just to jump between conversations. Right, so this is actually quite useful if you want to use Cursor CLI in your CI/CD pipeline and you actually want to just execute it. You could run something like this, Cursor agent chat, and you could say find and fix all security vulnerabilities, print output JSON format, and you can actually have a process after this to pick up whatever the format was and then pass it back into the next function. This is an empty project, so it shouldn't find anything, but we'll give it a we'll wait a second. Okay, we can see now it's running. This is if we do the output format by text. It's got a very long time to work. All right, so looking at this, we can see it just gave us some very generic security recommendations. Well, the prompt is very open, so it could give us anything we wanted. But that covers Cursor CLI. It's interesting to see how many AI tools are just running to the CLI. I think we're moving to a world where we actually want to run everything in GitHub Actions and your CI/CD processes and run multiple agents using the terminal and pass information from one to another. And I think this is just the first step that we're seeing all these AI companies moving toward. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.